Hey, I'm Chris. Watch me build a song from scratch in 11 minutes. Now, did it take me 11 minutes to build it? Nah, but it takes you 11 minutes to watch it. Stay tuned.
Previously on Song Builders TV, we're talking song recycling, taking something outdated from your old catalog and updating it for today.
Pick through 2 to 3 songs from your old catalog. And I'm willing to bet you, with a little light touch up or updating, at least one out of those 3 joints, you're going to find greatness. So let's test that theory.
I found a couple of my old demo CDs, some of these songs 20 plus years old. And from these, I'm picking 2 to 3 songs to update for today. So the song I'm picking for this episode is called Look No Further.
There's a couple things that I know wouldn't translate well to right here and now. All the different chord changes, all the different sections. I probably have to take one groove in there and make it the thing. More repetition in a new version than in the old. The guitar part can still stay. I think I archived it somewhere. It might be on here, but I got like 5 more like it upstairs, so we'll see. You might find that part. So you might recognize the hook of that song as the bridge of Happily Ever After. Happily Ever After was done for some friends of mine's wedding. It was never supposed to really see the light of day. So after I finished the 2 verses and the hook came, I was just rushing the bridge out. And so that bridge, I just quickly did like 2 parts of songs I already had that were sitting on shelves. Look No Further was one of them, and another song that I had called If You Stay. That song, If You Stay, ended up wrapped up with this girls group that Teddy Riley had that he didn't come out with. Now, what's funny is that I really believed in Look No Further. I thought it was a way better record than Happily Ever After. But as fate would have it, Happily ended up hitting market first. And once it hit market, Look No Further became an unshoppable song. But now that it's 20-some years later, might be time to revisit it.
So how can we update this song for the 2020s? Let's rebuild.
So for Look No Further, I'm trying to find a tempo that's fast enough not to drag. But at the same time, it's got to be slow enough for you to sing to it. Melodic rap is one thing, but singing is another. Let me see. Stay to the end and tell me who you'd love to hear on the record. So try to see what the right tempo is. Let's sing along with it a little bit. Have to look no further than me. Still a little slow. So I settled on 138.
Was that a good choice? What are some other songs with the same tempo?
If you look as good as Oprah's book, don't.
Back home, I'm no president, I'm Obama, ayy. I condone the drama. We kinda hit lit. That's tough. That's tough. That's tough. That's tough. That's
tough. I'm moonwalking in the 650 with the kit. Moonboxing this.
Go from the south to the booth. Make it up back in one loop. Give me the loop.
17-5, same color t-shirt. White.
I think I'm gonna split up the phrase. Do part of it in electric piano and do part of it in piano song. So next is this bass line. Now I'm torn between like a synth bass and an 808, but I think I'll try it out first with the 808, keep it more youth friendly. So let's mess with the pitch bend. You know what I'm saying? Let's hit it. One of my rules of thumb of starting out a sequence is to keep it down to 3 or 4 instruments, tops plus drums. So for that coveted 4th spot, I'm thinking nothing else but my little whine Moog. Yeah, let's get that. Now I went over how I created this sound in my Blame It episode, so you can look back at that. It was pretty fast. But I pretty much know how to make it on any synth plugin. I want to keep the drums minimal, so I'll just kind of hit the little spaces. All right, let's get it. I'm gonna bounce this down and transfer it to Pro Tools. I'm just so used to recording vocals on Pro Tools, but I promised myself that I will get better at recording vocals in Logic in the future because it'll just save time in my process. But for now. Now with some songs, you could be lyrically stuck in an era or soundscape stuck in an era. Like certain drum sounds can definitely lock you in a certain set of years. Certain lyrics and slang is gonna definitely date your song.
You don't have to look no further than me.
Now listening to the hook again, one thing that does bother me is the word loving. It's just not a word that's used anymore in songs. I feel like loving died in the 90s.
My loving. Good loving.
You're gonna miss my loving.
Good loving.
Need some loving.
Yeah, that word is dead. Now, how would I swap out that word? What's another two-syllable word for loving that's used in songs today? Yeah, but I can't disrespect the classic wedding song like that, so. My love's like the 90s R&B. That might work. Yeah, let's try that. Might be dumb, might be dope, but hear me out. It's a title that you might stop on. It's kind of a punchline. It's kind of a catchphrase. I've even seen that phrase on shirts, like, if it's not like that 90s R&B, I don't want it. And it also kind of answers some of the lyrical questions as far as concept. This one's just something to have fun with. Just, I'm gonna think of all kind of 90-isms. Like, just draw from memory, start freestyling favorite lines or favorite melodies from 90s records. Now, it does open a can of worms. There'll definitely be some samples to clear, well, interpolations to clear. I try not to worry about the future too much when you're just trying to vibe and feel creative and just put a record idea down. You know, you can always change it as roadblocks come. But for experience sake, let's go with the creative flow, deal with one issue at a time. Plus, it does give me an opportunity to go through a sample clearance or interpolation clearance process with you guys so we can all learn something. All right, now try to picture with a female singing it. Bear with me. Oh, and I found that guitar part, by the way.
I'ma throw it back, throw it way back, back, same.
All right. Now, remember in the 90s joints, well, the 90s and the early 2000s joints, they always had that, like, little radio effect.
You are.
Somebody singing and then they sing back and I think I'm gonna take that part, the throwback part, and so basically any EQ that you got, take this part that says high pass, set that up, and then just remove all those lows, put that high pass filter on it. On your EQ. Add just a little distortion, and then you got. Alright, that's out the way. So let's see what happens.
Hey, hey, I get so frustrated trying to save us on my mind. Hey, shuffle through songs, try to find some relating to you and I. The way I feel inside. Nothing these days wanna say shit, so I play that old school. You mean the world to me. You had me knocking down before quarantine. And
hold up, pause. You're not using your imagination. Run it back. Now imagine a female singing. Let's go.
Hey, hey,
I'ma show it back.
Through songs trying to find some relating to you and I. The way I'm feeling say nothing these days wanna say shit, so I play that old school. You mean the world to me. You had me locking down before quarantine. And I don't want to believe our love's terminal. And I trust that
you already know.
Don't want to believe our love's terminal.
Okay.
All right, so yeah, pick up the pace a little bit.
Don't want to believe our love's terminal.
And again, one more time.
Okay, you're getting the technical right, so now bring it back to your comfortable voice and your tone. I'm gonna play it for you just so you kind of know the inspiration behind it, so you can kind of know.
Don't
want to
believe that love's terminal, right?
Yeah. On bended knee. So I hope you picked up something here to help you build better songs in your own catalog. And as always, peace and keep building.